is a bonus video for this series with examples of managing a communicative language classroom. These methods are useful for large classes. They help to create a setting where students can communicate easily with one another. Pairing students at random. The teacher asks students to line up so she can assign random partners. Students talk to find their order in line and get to know all of their classmates.
Let's stand up and make a line by your birthdays. January at the front, December at the end.
February, May, December.
Okay, now bring the line around. The person across from you is your partner. This group, tell about your families. This group, listen and take notes. Please have a seat. Please line up by the time you woke up this morning. Who woke up early? Stand here. Who woke up later? Stand here. Okay, now let's divide here. You will be shopkeepers, and you will be shoppers.
Cooperative learning. In their cooperative learning groups, students create a conversation. In groups of four, students can choose from these roles. The writer puts the group's ideas on paper. The checker looks up spellings or meanings of words, asks questions, and watches the time. The leader starts the group on the assignment and makes sure everyone helps and understands. The speaker introduces the group's conversation and contributes to group work.
Work with your group to write a conversation about food. Each group has a leader, writer, and speaker.
Return to teacher focus from group work. When students have been working in small groups, the teacher may need to call attention back to herself in order to change to the next activity. In Unit 6, she has them count down together to begin the next activity.
Class, 2 minutes left. Please finish your work soon. Okay, class, time's up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Are you ready?
Yes.
Good.
Surveying student pair work. Sometimes teachers need to know if student groups have completed enough work to share with the class. In Unit 8, the teacher asks students to hold their fingers up against their throats to show her how many hopes and dreams notes they have written about their partners.
What did you hope to be?
They wanted to be a scientist.
You hoped to be what do you?
Okay, time's up. Now show me the number of notes you have by placing that number of fingers on your throat. Nice work.
Flipping the classroom. In a flipped classroom, students read and write at home. Then in class, they speak and apply the learning strategies. In Unit 9, students wrote an interview at home.
What was your homework? Mimi, please read the project assignment to help us remember.
1. Choose a job. 2. What do you need to be able to do that job? Make a list. 3. Write a dialogue with two people, you and an interviewer. 4. Bring the dialogue to class.
Thank you for watching the Let's Teach English series. Like all VOA Learning English materials, this series is free for you to use and share.